neke gospodine, da kroz njegova usta i da izlazi riječ koja je potrebna za naše spasenje. Neka sve bude po tvojoj milosti i tvojoj dobroti. Ti koji živiš i kraljuješ u vijeke vijekom.
Amen.
Izvolite se s tim. Evo, hvala Isuse Marija. Hvala vam lijepa da ste došli večeras u našu crkvu. Mi kao župa nalazimo se u pripremi za proslavu zaštitnice naše nebeske majke, zaštitnice naše župe, Marije uznesene na nebo. I evo, u sklopu te devetnice je i ova večer u kojoj je naš dragi Marino gost. Ja bih vas zamolio jedan aplauz za našeg Marina. Gospodina Marina, ja pretpostavljam da ga već poznajete možda čitajući njegove knjige ili ste možda poslušali njegove, slušali ste njegove govore koji su na YouTube-u, ali evo, i prošle godine,
talking about your last year, about the books and the YouTube and all the talks.
I kako je taj susret njegov život promijenio i učinio evo, sve tim, učinio drugačiji. Drago mi je izuzetno što Marino na jedan način svjedočeći Krista koji je njega dotakao, on ima svoj nastavak priče, a taj nastavak je on želi upozoriti na braće i sestre na one sakrivene stvari koje su oko nas i žele nas oteti od gospodina. Pa evo, neka stvarno gospodin bude s njim i neka nam progovori o onome što je potrebno za naše spasenje. Dragi Marino, dobro došao i evo, neka te gospodin nadahnuje.
Imam golem ovu, it's too big, so I will read here.
It's okay.
Okay, okay. It's very big. Okay, I can on this side. Good. Okay, you can start.
Praise the Jesus.
Hvaljen Isus. Hvaljen Isus.
I give thanks to God for the blessing and the opportunity to be with all of you here this evening.
Zahvaljujem gospodinu na blagoslovu i prigodi što mogu biti s vama večeras.
And I thank Father for his invitation and his support.
I zahvaljujem velečasnom na pozivu i na potpori.
I was invited by Father to share with you a reflection about the ideologies of this world, enemies of the people of God.
Veličasni me pozvao i zamolio da vam da s vama podijelim razmatranje o ideologijama ovoga svijeta, o zapravo neprijateljima Božjega naroda.
And we are also preparing for a big feast tomorrow.
A također pripremamo se za veliku sutra za veliko slavlje.
The crowning of Our Lady.
Krunidbu naše Gospe.
So I'm going to start with a reading from Galatians 5 from 13 on.
Počet ću jednim čitanjem iz poslanice Galačanima broj 4 od 13 do 26.
True freedom. You brothers and sisters were called to enjoy freedom. I am not speaking of that freedom which gives the free rein to the desires of the flesh, but of that which makes you slaves of one another through love. For the whole law is summed up in this sentence: you should love your neighbor as yourself. But if you bite and tear each other to pieces, be careful lest you all perish. Therefore I say to you, walk according to the Spirit and do not give way to the desires of the flesh. For the desires of the flesh war against the Spirit, and the desires of the Spirit are opposed to the flesh. Both are in conflict with each other, so that you cannot do everything you would like. But let the Spirit lead you. This has nothing to do with submitting to the law. You will know what comes from the flesh: immorality, impurity, and shamelessness, idol worship and magic, hatred, jealousy and violence, anger, ambition, division, factions and envy, drunkenness, orgies and the like. I again say to you what I have already said: those who do these things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is charity, joy, and peace, patience, understanding of others, kindness and fidelity, gentleness and self-control. For such things there is no law or punishment. Those who belong to Christ have crucified the flesh with its vices and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us live in a spiritual way. Let us not be conceited. Let there be no rivalry or envy of one another.
Doista, prostite, to je poslanica Galaćanima broj 5. Doista, vi ste, braćo, na slobodu pozvani. Samo neka ta sloboda ne bude izlikom tijelu, nego ljubavlju služite jedni drugima. Da sav je zakon ispunjen u jednoj jedinoj riječi, u ovoj: ljubi bližnjega svoga kao sebe samoga. Ako li pak jedni druge grizete i glođete, pazite da jedni druge ne proždrete. Hoću reći, po duhu živite, pa nećete ugađati požudi tijela, jer tijelo žudi protiv duha, a duh protiv tijela. Doista, to se jedno drugomu protivi, da ne činite što hoćete. Ali ako vas duh vodi, niste pod zakonom. A očita su djela tijela. To su bludnost, nečistoća, razvratnost, idolopoklonstvo, vraćanje, neprijateljstva, svađa, ljubomor, srdžbe, spletkarenja, razdori, strančarenja, zavisti, pijančevanja, pijanke i tome slično. Unaprijed vam kažem, kao što vam već rekoh, koji tako što čine, kraljestva Božjega neće baštiniti. Plod je pak duha: ljubav, radost, mir, velikodušnost, uslužnost, dobrota, vjernost, blagost, uzdržljivost. Protiv tih nema zakona. Koji su Kristovi, razapeše tijelo sa strastima i požudama. Ako živimo po duhu se i ravnajmo. Ne hlepimo za taštom slavom, ne izazivajmo jedni druge, ne zaviđajmo jedni drugima. Riječ Gospodnja.
We are all aware of what ideologies are about.
Svi smo mi svjesni o kakvim se ideologijama radi.
We have gender ideology.
Imamo rodnu ideologiju.
It has become like an alternative to common beliefs.
Koja je gotovo postala alternativa uobičajenim vjerovanjima.
And it has become a political movement.
I ona je postala jedan politički pokret.
A real dark agenda.
Sa doista mračnim programom, projektom.
With terrifying results.
Sa strahotnim rezultatima.
Because it is the destruction of the family.
Jer ona znači uništenje, razaranje obitelji.
The perversion of the children.
Izopačenje djece.
The propagation of abortion.
Propagiranje abortusa.
And all kinds of dark beliefs.
I sve vrste mračnih vjerovanja.
As people of God, we know that doesn't come from God.
Kao Božji ljudi, mi znamo da to ne dolazi od Boga.
And we live in a society today.
A danas živimo u društvu
that is trying to make us believe
koje nas pokušava uvjeriti
that all of these things are normal.
Da su sve, da je sve to normalno.
That is the new life we should adopt to live.
Da je to jedan novi život koji moramo svi prihvatiti i živjeti.
Almost like telling us that if we don't live like that,
gotovo da nam kažu ako tako nećemo živjeti,
we are outside time.
Da smo izvan vremena.
We are not up to date.
Nismo moderni.
And make us feel intimidated.
I pokušavaju nas zastrašiti.
To the point where this society today
do te mjere da ovo današnje društvo
is pretending to push believers against the wall.
Se pretvara da naš vjernike gura pred zid.
So we are confronted with a very difficult battle.
Dakle, suočeni smo sa vrlo teškom bitkom.
Because this is a time where we have to testify our faith.
Jer ovo su vremena u kojima moramo svjedočiti svoju vjeru.
For you Croatians,
za vas Hrvate,
to be in a battle to defend your faith is not a new battle.
Braniti, biti u bitci kojom branite svoju vjeru nije ništa novo.
Because you have been through communism,
jer ste prošli komunizam,
that left so many Croatian martyrs,
u kojemu je bilo mnogo hrvatskih žrtava.
Those that die for the faith.
Onih koji su umrli za vjeru.
And those that made it possible for you to be here in this church today.
A oni su vama omogućili da danas budete u ovoj crkvi.
Because their blood made it possible for you to be Catholics today in Croatia.
Jer je njihova krv omogućila da vi danas u Hrvatskoj budete katolici.
And you have battles so difficult like the battle you had with the Serbians.
Dakle, imali ste vrlo velike i teške bitke kao što ste imali sa Srbima.
That came and destroyed the Catholic churches and killed so many Catholics.
Koji su došli i uništavali, razarali katoličke crkve i ubili jako mnogo katolika.
So you know about a battle to defend Catholicism.
Dakle, vi znate što znači voditi bitku za obranu katoličanstva.
But the devil always changes his strategies.
Ali đava uvijek mijenja strategiju.
Today the new war, the new type of war,
danas nova vrsta rata,
is an ideological war.
Jest ideološki rat.
Which is much more dangerous than any other war.
Koji je opasniji, taj rat je opasniji od bilo kojeg drugog rata.
Because this war penetrates our homes.
Jer on prodire u naš dom
through the social media,
preko društvenih medija,
through the education of our children,
preko obrazovanja i odgoja djece,
sometimes even through our church,
ponekad čak i preko naše crkve.
Because unfortunately we find today clergy and laity,
jer nažalost danas možemo naći svećenika i laika
that have become worldly,
koji su postali ljudi od ovoga svijeta,
and that believe in those ideologies,
i koji vjeruju u te ideologije.
Thank God you don't have too much of that in Croatia yet.
Hvala Bogu, vi u Hrvatskoj još nemate mnogo takvih ljudi.
But I have seen that in many places of the Catholic Church in the world.
Ali sam mnogo toga vidio u mnogim zemljama katoličkoga svijeta.
So we need to understand how important it is.
Moramo shvatiti koliko je važno
for us Catholics to testify our doctrine.
Da mi katolici svjedočimo svoje učenje.
To testify the sacred traditions of our faith.
Da svjedočimo svetu predaju naše vjere.
To not be afraid and not let anybody intimidate us.
Da se ne bojimo i da ne dopustimo da nas itko zastrašuje.
As long as we are faithful and obedient Catholics.
Sve dok smo katolici koji imaju duboku vjeru i dok smo poslušni Bogu.
As long as we are in obedience to our church.
Sve dok smo poslušni našoj crkvi.
Obeying the Pope and obeying our hierarchy.
dok smo poslušni Svetom Ocu Papi i crkvenoj hijerarhiji,
the devil will not be able to touch us.
Đavao neće biti sposoban taknuti nas.
Because he or she that obeys will never fail.
Jer onaj tko sluša, koje posko živi u poslušnosti, nikada ne pada.
So we can never negotiate the principles of our faith.
Dakle, nikada ne smijemo praviti kompromise s načelima naše vjere.
We know that marriage is a man and a woman under the sacrament of the church.
Mi znamo da brak znači zajednica muškarca i žene po sakramentu crkve.
The world is trying to give us an alternative to marriage.
Svijet nam pokušava dati jednu alternativu ovakvom braku.
A man with a man, a woman with a woman.
Brak između muškarca i muškarca, između žene i žene.
And they trying to teach us that is normal.
I nastoje nas učiti da je to normalno.
That we have to be inclusive.
Da moramo biti inkluzivni.
That God loves all of us.
Da nas Bog sve voli.
And they play with our faith.
I igraju se s našom vjerom.
They manipulate our faith.
Oni manipuliraju našu vjeru.
And Catholics that are weak in the faith.
I katolici čija je vjera slaba.
They let themselves be influenced by this.
Dopuste da to utječe na njih.
But this is the time when we have to stay on our roots.
Ali ovo su vremena kada moramo biti čvrsti na svojim korijenima.
There is no other matrimony than man and woman.
Nema nikakvog drugog braka osim onoga između muškarca i žene.
And we are not judging homosexuals or lesbians.
Mi time ne osuđujemo homoseksualce ili lezbijke.
Because they are sinners like you and me.
Jer i oni su griješnici kao svi mi.
But we are denouncing the sin of homosexuality and lesbianism.
Ali osuđujemo grijeh homoseksualnosti i lezbijstva.
We have to separate the sinner from the sin.
Moramo odvojiti griješnika od grijeha.
God loves the sinner.
Bog voli griješnika.
But God hates the sin.
Ali Bog mrzi grijeh.
So we despise homosexuality.
Dakle, mi preziremo homoseksualnost.
But we are not judging homosexuals.
Ali ne osuđujemo homoseksualce.
We pray for them to convert.
Molimo se za njih da se obrate.
Because you can never say that homosexuality is a natural thing.
Jer nikada ne možemo reći da je homoseksualnost nešto prirodno.
Saint Paul says that sodomites will not enter the kingdom of God.
Sveti Pavao kaže da ljudi sodomci neće ući u Božje kraljevstvo.
And this is the word of God.
A to je Božja riječ.
When we read the letters of Saint Paul,
kada čitamo poslanice Svetoga Pavla,
at the end we say the word of God.
Na kraju kažemo riječ Gospodnja.
Because Saint Paul is considered one of the columns of the church.
Jer Svetog Pavla se drži kao jednog stupa crkve.
So everything he said was inspired by the Holy Spirit.
Dakle, sve što je on rekao bilo je nadahnuto od Duha Svetoga.
It was not made up by him.
On to nije, Sveti Pavao to nije izmislio.
But he was denouncing sin, not the sinner.
Ali Sveti Pavao je osuđivao grijeh, a ne griješnika.
So homosexuality is a demon.
Homoseksualnost je demon.
Lesbianism is a demon.
Isto tako i lezbijstvo.
And God will be merciful with those that repent.
Bog će biti milosrdan prema onima koji se pokaju.
So as Catholics we pray for all those people that have such a confused sexuality.
Dakle, moramo moliti za sve one ljude koji imaju zbrkanu spolnost.
But we will never accept the marriage between a man and a man and a woman and a woman.
Ali nikada nećemo prihvatiti brak između muškarca, dva muškarca ili dvije žene.
Because that is not of God.
Jer to nije od Boga.
And it's very important that we have the clarity that we're speaking about.
I vrlo je jasno, vrlo je važno da nam bude jasno ovo o čemu govorimo.
You know, you will be surprised if I tell you.
Bićete iznenađeni ako vam kažem.
I'm sure for you people it's very normal what I'm saying.
Siguran sam da je vama koji slušate normalno ovo što ja govorim.
But so many Catholics in other countries in the world have become so confused.
Ali ima mnogo katolika u drugim zemljama svijeta koji su postali toliko zbunjeni
that they are beginning to think it is normal.
Da počinju misliti kako je to normalno.
I have been in churches in the United States.
Bio sam u raznim crkvama, u više crkava u Americi.
In Canada.
Kanadi.
In England.
Engleskoj.
Where they have masses for homosexuals and lesbians.
U kojima imaju mise za homoseksualce i lesbijke.
And they come as couples hand by hand and take communion.
I oni dolaze kao parovi, drže se za ruke i dolaze tako na pričest.
And the priest is a homosexual.
A svećenik, sam svećenik je homoseksualac.
So we need to pray a lot for our church.
Dakle, moramo mnogo moliti za našu crkvu.
Because the devil is furious.
Zato što je đavao bijesan.
Because his time is running out.
A bijesan je zato što mu vrijeme istječe.
And there is nothing that Satan hates more.
A nema ništa što Satana mrzi više
than the Catholic Church.
Od katoličke crkve.
Because the Catholic Church is the Church of God.
Zato što je katolička crkva Božja crkva.
So he wants to crush it.
Pa je on zato želi smrviti.
He wants to pervert it.
Želi je izopačiti.
He wants to confuse it.
Želi je zbuniti.
We have to be strong.
Moramo biti jaki.
We cannot let the ideologies of this world in any way influence us.
Ne smijemo dopustiti da ideologije ovoga svijeta i na koji način na nas utječu.
We have to teach our children the right catechism.
Moramo svoju djecu učiti pravom katekizmu.
Because even the catechism, some catechists are changing it.
Jer neki katekisti čak mijenjaju katekizam.
And adapting it to these ideologies.
I prilagođavaju ga ovim ideologijama.
So we have to be on guard.
Zato moramo biti na oprezu.
Because this is a new type of war.
Zato što je ovo nova vrsta rata.
When Our Lady of Fatima appeared to the shepherds,
kada se Gospa Fatimska ukazala pastirima,
she told them that the World War I was going to end.
Rekla im je da će prvi svjetski rat završiti.
But she said, if humanity will not repent, a much worse war will come.
Ali je rekla, ako se čovječanstvo ne pokaje, doći će jedan još gori rat.
And humanity didn't repent.
I ljudi se nisu pokajali.
Didn't change.
Nisu se promijenili.
And then World War II began.
A onda je došao drugi svjetski rat.
It was a disastrous war.
Bio je to strahotan rat.
And then Our Lady didn't say what will happen if humanity wouldn't change after World War II.
Gospa nije rekla što će se dogoditi ako se ljudi ne promijene, dakle što će se dogoditi poslije drugog svjetskog rata.
So we know that meant that then humanity will be helpless.
Znamo da će, dakle, čovječanstvo biti bespomoćno.
And you know, humanity didn't change after World War II.
A čovječanstvo se nije promijenilo ni poslije drugog svjetskog rata.
Humanity turned even more degenerate.
Čak se i još više izopačilo.
The sins of humanity today are more perverse than any sin in any empire in the past.
Današnji grijesi današnjeg čovječanstva izopačeniji su od svih grijeha poznatih u povijesti čovječanstva.
Today we have massive movements in the world.
Danas imamo masovne na svijetu masovne pokrete.
propagating abortion,
koji promiču pobačaj,
homosexuality,
homoseksualnost,
all kinds of realities in society that are completely against God.
Sve stvarnosti u društvu koje su potpuno protiv Boga.
So they have perverted fashion,
izopačili su modu,
music,
glazbu,
art,
umjetnost,
literature,
književnost,
and all the social media,
i sve društvene medije.
And we are in the middle of all of this.
Dakle, mi živimo u svemu tome.
And when I speak about all these dark things,
kada ja govorim o svim tim mračnim stvarima,
it's not because I came here to give you a dark message.
Ne činim to da bi vam, da bi došao k vama i dao vam nekakvu mračnu poruku.
It's because God wants us to be awakened.
Nego zato što Bog želi da budemo budni.
Because we are the chosen people of God.
Zato što smo mi Božji odabrani narod.
And we are responsible for the salvation of souls.
I odgovorni smo za spasenje duša.
And that's why we have to be wise.
Pa zato moramo biti mudri.
And we have to be brave and courageous.
Moramo biti hrabri. Hrabri i hrabri, da.
To speak up the truth.
Govoriti istinu.
Not to be afraid to say the truth.
Ne smijemo se bojati reći istinu.
Not to ever be intimidated.
Nikada ne smijemo biti zastrašeni.
Because your own children are going to confront you.
Jer će vam se vlastita djeca suprotstaviti.
Because they're going to be told in the school or in the media.
Zato što će im u školi ili u medijima reći.
About these terrible ideologies.
Govoriti o tim strašnim ideologijama.
And they're going to come to ask you.
I doći će kući i pitati vas.
And you have to be very clear.
I morate im vrlo jasno odgovoriti.
You have to know what you're saying.
Morate znati što im govorite.
To be able to protect them.
Da biste ih uspjeli zaštititi.
Because many voices are talking to our children today.
Jer danas mnogi glasovi govore našoj djeci.
So our voice has to be the voice that is the most clear and the most truthful.
Zato naš glas mora biti glas koji je najjasniji i najistinitiji.
Because when you speak the truth of God,
jer kada govorite Božju istinu,
it goes directly into the heart.
Ona ide izravno u srce.
And that's why you have to speak it up with conviction.
Zato morate tu istinu govoriti s uvjerenjem.
So the heart of your children can be filled with that truth.
Tako da se srce vaše djece ispuni tom istinom.
And so that nobody can corrupt them.
I da ih nitko ne može pokvariti.
And our church needs testimonies.
Našoj crkvi su potrebna svjedočanstva.
We are not only Catholics that come to mass.
Mi nismo samo katolici koji idu na svetu misu.
Or that come to baptize the children or bury the dead.
Ili koji dolaze u crkvu kad treba krstiti dijete ili kad treba pokopati nekog mrtvaca.
Our church is much more than that.
Naša crkva mnogo više od toga.
Our church is a militia.
Naša crkva je vojska.
We are members of an army.
Mi smo pripadnici vojske.
For the defense of souls.
Za obranu duša.
So when we come to church, we come to strengthen ourselves.
Zato kada dolazimo u crkvu, mi se dolazimo ojačati.
To receive from God the strength and the wisdom we need.
Da bismo od Boga dobili snagu i mudrost koji su nam potrebni.
This evening we are all here because God gathered us here.
Večeras smo ovdje zato što nas je Bog ovdje okupio.
And why did God gather us here this evening?
A zašto nas je Bog ovdje okupio?
Because he wants to prepare us.
Zato što nas želi pripraviti.
Because he wants to make us strong.
Zato što nas želi ojačati.
Because he wants to open our eyes.
Zato što nam želi otvoriti oči.
To see the world where we are living.
da vidimo svijet u kojemu živimo.
So we don't fall asleep.
Dakle, da ne zaspemo.
You know, the biggest trick of Satan against the people of God?
Najveća varka, trik Sotone protiv Božih ljudi,
is to keep you very busy with this transitory life.
Jest to da nas sve jako zaokupi ovim prolaznim životom.
So that you don't have any time to look at the action of the Spirit.
Pa da vam ne ostane nimalo vremena da razmišljate o djelovanju duha.
So Satan comes in and out of your life and you don't even notice it.
Tako Sotona ulazi u vaš život i izlazi iz njega, a da vi to ni ne opažate.
Because you are only worried about your temporal life.
Zato što ste skroz zabrinuti i zaokupljeni vremenitim životom.
So the spirits are roaming freely around you.
U takvoj situaciji duhovi slobodno tumaraju oko vas.
And the next thing you know, they got you all confused with all these new ideologies.
I vrlo brzo shvatite da su oni uspjeli vam potpuno zbrkati u glavi sve ove ideologije.
Because you were not paying attention.
Zato što niste pazili.
So this is a time when we have to be alert.
Ovo su vremena kada moramo biti budni.
You probably noticed something very strange.
Vjerojatno ste opazili nešto vrlo čudno.
Homosexuals and lesbians are a minority.
Homoseksualci i lezbijke su manjina.
An amazingly small minority.
Nevjerojatno malena manjina.
And is the biggest lobby in the world.
Ali oni su najjači, najveći lobby na svijetu.
You see them in every newspaper, in every magazine.
Vidite ih u svim novinama, u svim časopisima.
In every movie, in every TV series.
U svakoj televizijskoj seriji, u svakom filmu.
All over the social media.
U svim društvenim medijima.
And you ask yourself, how can they be so big in popularity?
I pitate se kako je moguće imati tako veliku popularnost
when they are such a small minority.
U situaciji kada su oni zapravo vrlo malena manjina.
So the answer is, it's because there is a big power behind them.
Odgovor je sljedeći. To je zato što iza njih ima jedna velika sila.
And the big power is called Masons.
A ta velika sila zove se masoni.
The Masons are the ones propagating the popularity of homosexuality.
Masoni su zapravo oni koji propagiraju popularnost homoseksualnosti.
And also feminism.
I feminizma.
And abortion.
I pobačaj.
And why? Why?
A zašto?
Because they are satanic.
Zato što su oni se predali Sotoni.
So everything they do to favor what Satan is asking from them.
Dakle, sve što god oni čine ono zapravo što Sotona od njih traži.
I'm going to give you evidence.
Daću vam dokaz za to.
When Jesus was tempted in the desert,
kada je Isus bio kušan u pustinji,
the devil took him to a mountain.
Đavao ga je odveo na jednu planinu.
And show him all the kingdoms of the world.
I pokazao mu je sva kraljevstva ovoga svijeta.
And told him, everything has been given to me.
I rekao mu je, sve je ovo meni dano.
If you kneel and worship me, I give it to you.
Ako klekneš i pokloniš mi se, sve ću ti ovo dati.
So Jesus let us know that Satan runs this world.
Dakle, time nas Isus obavještava da Sotona upravlja ovim svijetom.
Jesus told us the prince of this world is Satan.
Isus nam je rekao da je knez ovoga svijeta Sotona.
So Masons worship Satan.
Dakle, masoni se klanjaju Sotoni.
And Satan gives them power.
I Satana im daje moć.
The power that Satan offered to Jesus.
Onu istu moć koju je Satana ponudio Isusu.
So it is a fact because Jesus showed us what Satan was offering to him.
To je činjenica zato što nam je Isus pokazao što mu je Satana nudio.
And that's what he gives to everyone that enters into Satanism.
To Satana daje svakome tko uđe u satanizam.
So the biggest price they have to pay to Satan,
najveća cijena koju moraju uplatiti Satani,
is the blood of the innocent.
Je krv nevinih.
So abortion is the biggest payment to Satan from Masons.
Pobačaj je najveća plaća Satani od Masona.
And everything that stops procreation.
I sve ono što čime se zaustavlja rađanje.
They invented the marriage of a man with a man and a woman with a woman.
Oni su izmislili brak između dva muškarca i između dvije žene.
It's the most incredible mockery against God.
To je najveće moguće ruganje Bogu.
It's laughing at God.
To je ismijavanje Boga.
Because a man and a man cannot procreate.
Zato što muškarac i muškarac, dva muškarca, ne mogu rađati djecu.
We know as Catholics that we are part of the economy of salvation.
Mi kao katolici znamo da smo, da sudjelujemo, da smo dio ekonomije spasenja.
We are the new creation in Jesus Christ.
Mi smo novo stvaranje u Isusu Kristu.
And an exact number of human beings will enter heaven before Jesus returns.
I postoji točan broj ljudskih bića koji trebaju doći u nebo prije nego li Isus ponovno dođe.
That is the greatest part of the economy of salvation.
To je najveći dio ekonomije spasenja.
So Satan pretends to stop that.
Satana nastoji to zaustaviti.
He knows he cannot do it.
On zna da ne može to učiniti.
But Satan is 100% evil.
Ali on je 100% zao.
So he doesn't care if he loses.
Pa nije ga briga ako izgubi.
Because he has nothing to lose.
Zato što nema ništa, nema što izgubiti.
He already lost everything.
Već je, on je već sve izgubio.
So he tries to stop procreation.
Pa sada, dakle, nastoji zaustaviti rađanje.
By killing babies with abortion.
Tako što ubija djecu pobačajem.
Propagating homosexuality.
Tako što propagira homoseksualnost.
Feminism.
Feminizam.
And turning people into islands.
I pretvara ljude u otoke.
That's why all these movements they proclaim.
Zato svi ti pokreti koji oni proklamiraju.
About my freedom.
Koji kažu moja sloboda.
My rights.
Moja prava.
My independence.
Moja neovisnost.
And it's all about me.
Dakle, sve se to tiče mene, moga ja.
You know, when we speak as human beings about mine, me, mine.
Kada kao ljudska bića govorimo uvijek ja, ja, ja.
We speak about original sin.
Tada govorimo o istočnom grijehu.
Original sin was you will be like God.
Istočni grijeh je bio bit ćeš kao Bog.
And Adam and Eve went for that.
I Adam i Eva su pali na to.
And that's why death entered the world.
I zato je smrt ušla u svijet.
So the devil wants you to build you into self-centeredness.
Đavao želi da vi budete tako izgrađeni da budete najvažniji sami sebi.
So all these ideologies of the world.
Pa sve te svjetske ideologije.
They want to turn you into self-centeredness.
Žele pretvoriti čovjeka u osobu koji je sam sebi najvažniji.
And we as the people of God,
a mi kao Božji narod,
we are to be Christ-centered.
Mora nam u središtu biti Isus.
That's why Saint Paul says it's no longer I who lives.
Zato Sveti Pavao kaže ne živim više ja,
but Christ that lives in me.
Nego Isus koji živi u meni.
And we have to realize that the biggest teaching of our church,
i moramo shvatiti da da je najveće učenje naše crkve,
for a spiritual growth,
za duhovni rast,
is to learn how to die to self.
Jest naučiti kako umrijeti sebi.
That is absolutely the contrary of all the ideologies of this world.
To je potpuna suprotnost svim ideologijama ovoga svijeta.
We are not looking for our rights.
Mi ne tražimo svoja prava.
We are not looking for our independence.
Ne tražimo svoju neovisnost.
We are looking for Christ.
Mi tražimo Krista.
Our savior.
Našega spasitelja.
He is the only one we're looking for.
I samo njega tražimo.
Christ is our realization.
Krist je naše ostvarenje.
You notice that Eastern philosophies are very popular among Christians today.
Možda ste opazili da su istočnjačke filozofije vrlo popularne danas među kršćanima.
Many Christians have become Buddhists.
Mnogi su kršćani postali budisti.
Or Hinduists.
Ili hinduisti.
You notice all the Christians that practice all kinds of yogas.
A ima i mnogo kršćana koji se bave, koji prakticiraju sve vrste joge.
They became Christian Hindus.
Oni su postali nekakvi kršćano-hindusi.
And you know the teachings of Hinduism, that is a pagan philosophy.
A učenje hinduizma, a to je jedna poganska filozofija.
Are built on seven yogas.
Sazdano je na sedam yoga.
And they teach you about self-realization.
A one vas uče o samoostvarenju.
It's all about you.
Dakle, sve o ja, o mome ja.
They teach you about mental control.
Uče vas o mentalnoj kontroli.
Self-esteem.
Samopoštovanju.
And above all, self-realization.
I iznad svega o samoostvarenju.
Exactly the opposite of Christianity.
To je sve potpuno suprotno kršćanstvu.
Because we do not look for self-realization.
Jer mi ne tražimo samoostvarenje.
The only thing we want to realize in our life,
jedino što u svome životu želimo ostvariti,
is Jesus Christ in our heart.
Jest Isus Krist u našem srcu.
So we do not look for self.
Dakle, ne tražimo svoje ja.
We look for God.
Tražimo Boga.
And we know if we don't look for God,
i znamo ako ne tražimo Boga,
we are nothing.
Onda smo ništa.
Because God is the only one who is.
Jer Bog je jedini koji jest.
We are not.
Mi nismo.
If God is not in us,
ako Bog nije u nama,
we are only dust.
Onda smo samo prašina.
And in dust we will be converted at the end.
I na kraju ćemo se pretvoriti u prašinu.
So we need to be strong and wise.
Moramo biti jaki i mudri.
We need to understand that these are times when we have to be real Catholics.
Moramo shvatiti da su ovo vremena kada moramo biti pravi katolici.
And to be very proud of our faith.
I da moramo biti vrlo ponosni na svoju vjeru.
And not to be afraid.
A ne se bojati.
Today the church is celebrating the life of a deacon martyr.
Danas crkva slavi život
a deacon martyr.
Đakona mučenika.
And I said
Svetoga Lovru, okay.
And every time we celebrate a martyr in the liturgy,
kad god u liturgiji slavimo nekog mučenika,
the church is teaching us,
crkva nas uči,
you are Catholics because this martyr gave his blood for you.
Vi ste katolici zato što je ovaj mučenik za vas dao život.
So the most important question we have to ask ourselves today,
najvažnije pitanje koje sebi danas moramo postaviti,
is anybody going to be a Catholic because I gave my blood for them?
Dakle, hoće li itko postati katolik zato što sam ja prolio svoju krv?
Not only martyrdom is about bleeding.
Dakle, mučeništvo mučeništvo ne sadrži samo krvarenje, prolijevanje krvi.
Martyrdom is about being a Catholic against all odds.
Mučeništvo znači biti katolik nasuprot svim nedaćama.
Today being a true Catholic,
danas biti pravi katolik,
everywhere you go,
ako ste pravi katolik, kamo god idete,
it is some type of martyrdom.
To je neka vrsta mučeništva.
Because some people will close doors to you.
Jer će vam neki ljudi zatvoriti vrata.
Many people will not like you.
Mnogima se nećete svidjeti.
And many people will persecute you.
A mnogi će vas progoniti.
So this is a different type of martyrdom.
Dakle, ovo je drugčija vrsta mučeništva.
But if we persevere,
ali ako ustrajemo,
we will make it possible for others to be Catholic after us.
Onda ćemo time omogućiti drugima poslije nas da budu katolici.
Because we are responsible for the Catholic Church of today.
Zato što smo mi odgovorni za katoličku crkvu danas.
And depending on what we do with our faith to do today,
i ovisno o tome što mi učinimo sa svojom vjerom danas,
that's how many people are going to be Catholics in the future.
Ovisi, dakle, o tome ovisi broj ljudi u budućnosti koji će biti katolici.
So the future of the church depends on us.
Dakle, budućnost crkve ovisi o nama.
When you go before the tribunal of Jesus at the end of this life,
kada na kraju ovoga života dođete na Isusov sud,
the Lord is not going to ask you how much money you have.
Gospodin vas neće pitati koliko imate novca.
And how many titles you have.
I koliko titula imate.
And how important you became.
I koliko ste postali važni.
He's going to ask you how many people knows about me because of you.
Nego će vas pitati koliko je ljudi saznalo za mene zahvaljujući vama.
Because the only thing important that we take with us when we go,
jer jedino što je važno, što kao važno nosimo sa sobom kada odemo s ovoga svijeta,
is how much of God we were able to bring to people.
Yes, koliko smo Boga uspjeli donijeti ljudima.
Because the most important thing in this life to do,
jer ono najvažnije u ovome životu, što moramo u ovome životu učiniti,
is to bring God to people.
Činiti jest donositi Boga ljudima.
What is the biggest gift you can give to your family?
Koji je to najveći dar koji možete dati svojoj obitelji?
It's not your money or your fame or your talents.
Nije to ni novac, ni slava, ni talenti.
It's how much of God you can give them.
Nego koliko im Boga možete dati.
Because that is the only thing that is going to be forever.
Jer jedino to, jedino će to trajati vječno.
Everything else is going to be useless at the end.
Sve drugo će na kraju biti beskorisno.
So we need to understand this.
Zato moramo ovo shvatiti.
We have to fill ourselves with God.
Moramo ispuniti sebe Bogom.
And the only way to do that,
a jedini način na kojim to možemo učiniti,
is to be faithful and obedient to God.
Jest biti poslušan i poslušan Bogu.
And the Catholic Church is the master of that obedience.
A katolička crkva je učiteljica te poslušnosti.
Because this is the church of God.
Jer ona je Božja crkva.
And God left us the perfect school of the soul.
I Bog nam je ostavio savršenu školu duše.
So may God bless you.
Dakle, neka vas Bog blagoslovi.
And make you strong.
Neka vas ojača.
So that you can provide the territory for many Croatians to be Catholics after you go.
Tako da možete osigurati područje na kojemu mnogi katolici mogu biti, mnogi Hrvati mogu biti katolici kada vi odete s ovoga svijeta.
Amen.
Amen.